morning, boys and girls. Welcome to our church. We are so glad that you could join us today. How's everybody doing? How did your week go? Did you do any fun things this week? Awesome! Today is our second Sunday in our lesson series called True Love. But for now, who's in for a game? All right, let's play a game. Our game for today is called Guess the Food. It's an emoji challenge. Here's how to play it. You will guess the food by the emojis being used. Then you have 15 seconds each round to guess. So, if you've guessed it, shout your answer out loud. Okay? Okay, let's do the practice round. Guess the food? Go! Did you get it, kids? That was so easy, right? So, I think you are so ready for the first round. Okay, let's do it. Guess the food. Go! Guess it right? Good job! Let's do the second round. Guess the food? Go! Okay, so was that round so easy or not? Okay, let's do the third round. Guess the food, go! You are doing great, kids! Okay, are you ready for our final round? Alright, let's do this! Guess that food? Go! Did you guess what is it? Great! You are really good at playing games. Great job, everyone. Give yourselves a big thumbs up. One of the major qualities in a godly love is kindness. Love is kind. In today's lesson, we will discover how genuine love that comes from God means showing kindness to other people, even in our enemies. Let's check our Bible verse for today.
Hello and good morning, everyone. Are you ready for a Bible verse? Great! Let's look at our theme verse for this month. Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It is not proud, it does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4-7. Today, we are going to focus on the second part. It says, it does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no records of wrong. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 5. Would you say that with me this time, kids? Ready? Go! It does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no records of wrong. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 5. It is always great to learn verses from the Bible, because Bible is God's Word. And if it is God's Word, it is powerful. You are right, kids. God's Word is powerful. So can we say our verse one last time? Okay, here we go. It does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrong. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 5. Great job, everyone! It's time to worship Jesus. Let's give Him all our love through singing and dancing. So make sure you have enough space to move around. So let's get our hearts and minds ready to worship our loving God. Would you stand to your feet and raise your hands like this to Jesus, and let us pray this together. God, we welcome your presence today. Have your way in us.
That's a Snapchat. Boomerang with the praise and the right back. Man, we higher than the sky, no turn back. If it be our last night, leave it all here. No fear, be clear, this is your year. Let go of anything that isn't God's steer. Visine with a dream, and it's so clear. Yeah, so clear. And you know wherever you go, I'ma stick close, they gon' think we a duo. Bond so tight, hug it out like a sumo. And I never think twice, you the boss of my life, no Hugo. And this world not down with us. They can try to limit faith, but it's down to us. Man, love so deep, not a game to us. When the blessing come down, man, the praise go up, yeah.
Sky, your love is deeper than the sea. Your grace is washing over me and calling me your own higher than the sky. Your love is deeper than the sea. Your grace is washing.
worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, oh, we live for you. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, we live for you. Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder and show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you.
What I tell you who are listening, love your enemies. Do good to those who hate you. Bless those who call down curses on you. And pray for those who treat you badly. Suppose someone slaps you on one cheek. Let them slap you on the other cheek as well. Suppose someone takes your coat. Don't stop them from taking your shirt as well. give to everyone who asks you. And if anyone takes what belongs to you, don't ask to get it back. Do to others as you want them to do to you. Suppose you love those who love you. Should anyone praise you for that? Even sinners love those who love them. And suppose you do good to those who are good to you. Should anyone praise you for that? Even sinners do that. And suppose you lend money to those who can pay you back. Should anyone praise you for that? Even a sinner lends sinners, expecting them to pay everything back. But love your enemies, do good to them, lend to them without expecting to get anything back. Then you will receive a lot in return, and you will be children of the Most High God. He is kind to people who are evil and are not thankful. So have mercy, just as your Father has mercy. Luke 6:27-36.
That passage in Luke chapter 6, verse 27 to 36, Jesus was very clear that we should love others, even those who don't love us. Hello, boys and girls. It's good to see you again today. It's Bible time. There is a popular Bible story that illustrates that love is kind even to an enemy. In this story, the Jews had an enemy that lived very near to them. They were called Samaritans. When they traveled, Jewish people would do their best to walk around the land where the Samaritans lived. We can find this story in Luke chapter 10, verses 25 to 27.
Jesus told a story about a Jewish man who lived in Jerusalem. One day, the man decided to visit his friends in Jericho. He set out on his journey, enjoying the beautiful sunshine.
What a great day for a long walk.
But on his journey, two robbers appeared from out of nowhere.
Somebody help!
The robbers took the man's stuff and beat him up. They left him laying beside the road, nearly dead. Soon, a priest came along on the road. This seemed like good news since priests were known to be close to God and good helpers.
Please, help me.
But the priest saw the wounded man and he pretended he didn't. Instead, he crossed to the other side of the road and kept walking. Next, a man who worked in the temple walked by. This seemed like good news. If this guy worked in the temple, he must be close to God and willing to help.
Please, help me.
But the temple assistant pretended not to see the man dying beside the road. He crossed to the other side of the road and kept walking. Next, a Samaritan came along. The Jewish man didn't expect him to stop. Everyone thought Samaritans weren't very nice or helpful. But the most unexpected thing happened. The Samaritan stopped. He got into the ditch with the Jewish man and bandaged his wounds.
Thank you for stopping to help.
The Samaritan loaded the hurt man onto his donkey and took him to an inn. He paid for the Jewish man's room and asked for them to take care of him.
What happened to the man who was traveling to Jericho? He was robbed and beaten, nearly to death. Did you remember the priest and the Levite that passed by? How did they react when they saw the wounded man lying on the road? They passed him by on the other side of the road, who finally offered help. You are right, kids. A Samaritan. Do you remember what the Samaritan did for the wounded man? Yes, you are right. Cleaned him up and took him to an inn and gave money for his care. In this story, who do you think showed kindness? A relative or an enemy? An enemy. And what's even better is that the Samaritan did not expect anything in return for his kindness. Is it enough to love those who love us? No, it's not enough. Why do you think so? Because Jesus commands us to show love to everyone. Kids, why do you think Jesus chose a Samaritan, an enemy, to be the one to show kindness? Think. because Jesus wants to show us that true love does not have boundaries, neither ethnic, racial, geographical, nor religious. We know that it is important to love and to be kind to each other. But today we learned that Jesus wants us to love even to our enemies. That takes a very powerful kind of love that can only come from Jesus. But who is our enemy? It can be anyone who thinks differently from us, or disagrees with us, or who treats us badly. It can be a neighbor, a schoolmate, a relative, or even a friend. But if we are kind and loving to them, who knows? We may draw them to Jesus. And Jesus loves everyone, even those who put him to death on the cross. If Jesus can love people, even those who put him to death, surely we can love those who simply look down on us. Think about the love of Jesus as we pray together. Dear God, thank you for showing your love to us in so many ways. Thank you most of all for giving your son Jesus, who loves us so much. He would even die on the cross to save us. Lord, help me to be kind and loving to everyone, even those who don't love me. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Love is kind, it's not jealous anytime.
It's not proud and it's not rude. Love forgives and speaks the truth.
Oh, yeah, love will never fail. Oh, yeah, love will never fail.
Love protects, it does not break. It doesn't easily get mad. Love is hopeful and it trusts. When we love, we never give up.
Another fun-packed church service with you all, kids. Today, we discovered how genuine love that comes from God means showing kindness to other people, even our enemies. Would you do something specially nice to someone who makes you angry? Come back next week to find out if you should. We have an amazing time with you, kids. We'll see you next week. Be kind to everyone. God bless you all.